block it, man. If he goes this way, I'll be able to block it, bro, because I'm already blocking that way. Fuck it. Gay weirdos, dog. That's how I tell you. That's who plays this shit, man. Unskilled ass weirdos, bro, that are just like, it's pathetic, bro. Like, you gotta just think of that. Like, he's already like, just doing this nonstop. Please, please go that way. Please go that way so I can block it, man. I'm gonna block it. I'm not good enough to block it while he does it, so I wanna block it. I'm gonna pre block it, man. And just hopefully I get lucky. There's just a lot of these low level fighters. Guys that don't really know what they're doing. Nine times out of ten, that's what you're gonna get. Clown ass weirdo, bro. Don't know how to fight. They just like hoping to do it all. They're trying to get the way it's been. I'd say they don't really understand the fight game. They just know that. Yeah, they're just trying to really get fucking lean. He's running through a lot of money. This dude's division 4, though, he's terrible. Like, fucking literally terrible. I'm saying, like, why are they making fight these clowns, bro? Like, it's some competition. You ready? You ready?
Well, the tension is palpable as this fight gets underway, and gonna be interesting to see how this matchup plays out. Definite striker on one side against another guy who can really do it all.
And in those situations, normally the guy that's more well-rounded will be the one that will find success. I want to see how this plays out. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots from the top.
Close guard.
Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground.
Oh, huge elbow! Just over 3 minutes to go, round one.
Close guard here. He's very comfortable here working off of his back, DC.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
Lands with the grounded pound here. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity patting. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
Gets up again here, but hurting. 48 total strikes and counting have already found the mark for Yoel Romero. Once again, looking for that highlight reel KO with that front kick. Combination lands for him. It was hard to see a miss.
Oh! Huge right hand!
Back to the feet. A big knee. And now he lands a combination. Oh, big left. Thirty seconds now to go in round one. Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of mixing everything up.
And both guys really throwing with authority. And he lands a punch there. Pretty good connection by him.
Great connection. He's in a great flow right now.
Round two straight ahead. All right, so a big knockdown for him courtesy of that punch in that round. DC, here's a replay.
Big moment. In the previous round, they were both fighting very well. But when he landed this punch right here that sits his opponent down, it showed that the power is not equal. And if he can land, he does have the ability to damage him.